These are five irregular octagons. I think they might have begun in 69 and then they ended in 71. They have a peacefulness that is probably connected to the humiliation some of us felt about the war. Normally art involves itself with a composition in a rectangular format. These, the composition is as if from a center point, which you never know, to an exterior point. It's called white bond paper. It's something that's sold to kindergartens so that the teachers can line the walls and the kids are free to draw wherever they like, and they're not drawing on the wall, and maybe they can cut them up and take them home. It was important that the commonness or the inexpensiveness of it could be combined with the ambition that was the highest you could have in the field of art. The humbleness of these is actually balanced by this anything but humble ambition to create a new form. Immanence and transcendence are polarities, and that's the Asian in me. You don't look for disharmony, you look for harmony. So you would look for the place, a place, where you can get the most perfect balance between immanence and transcendence. And that's what I think is the ambition of these pieces. The gang of artists, you could say, who were attempting, this is Europeans as well as Americans, who were attempting to reintroduce the possibility of the transcendent in the arts, you know, which I recognized as important for me when I was a teenager, where you'd find them in the beat movement, you'd find them already playing a part of certain abstract expressionists, certainly the hippies. The transcendence that's within the whole picture was enormously attractive. And even in those days, people would talk about Zen not without knowing that there's like 10 kinds of Zen, or not knowing that it was a way of a non-verbal, non-linguistic way to enlightenment. You know, there was so little sophistication, yet people felt this. They felt this. Was the direction that, you know, we needed to go in to make a better world. You see in this whole show that these are artists who, one strongest motivation was making a better world. And I think it's so great that there's the Obama period that we have, you know, who's, you know, we are about to start making a better world, you know, and you have this bank of artists, you know, who have been dedicated in that same direction, you know, and you know, I'm sure people will see this show with this new spirit of energy and